Now we are going to discuss the blood vessels.
In
the upper limb. And in the upper limb, first we will take arteries of the upper limb. Arteries of the upper limb are the axillary artery and brachial artery and radial and ulnar arteries and superficial palmar arch and deep palmar arch. Arteries of the upper limb begin from axillary artery, and we know that the axillary artery is the continuation of subclavian artery, and subclavian artery was a terminal branch of brachiocephalic trunk on the right side, and it was a direct branch from the arch of aorta from the left side. And arch of aorta was continuation of ascending aorta, and ascending aorta was coming from the left ventricle of the heart. So blood comes from the left ventricle of the heart in the ascending aorta, in arch of aorta, in subclavian artery, and in axillary artery. So axillary artery then becomes continuous as the brachial artery, and brachial artery then divides into two, that is radial artery and ulnar artery, and in the palm, radial artery becomes continuous as the deep palmar arch, and ulnar artery becomes continuous as the superficial palmar arch. So the axillary, we have only these arteries, axillary, brachial, radial, ulnar and palmar arteries. This is only one artery, but their name are given according to their location. When the subclavian artery comes in the axilla, it changes its name as axillary artery. When axillary artery comes in the arm, it changes its name as brachial artery. Brachial means arm. Brachial plexus, brachial artery, biceps brachii, triceps. So these, and when the brachial artery comes in the forearm, it divides into two. One artery goes on the right lateral side. So lateral side means radial side, and ulnar side means ulnar side. So this is a radial artery and ulnar artery. And in the palm, you know, there are layers of the muscles in the palm. One palmar arch is formed superficial, one is formed deep. So we start from axillary artery. So axillary artery begins from the outer border of the first rib as the continuation of axillary artery. This at the continuation of subclavian artery. This was subclavian artery. When the subclavian artery reached to the outer border of the first rib, it changes its name as the axillary artery. Axillary artery courses in the axilla, and when the axillary artery reaches to the lower border of teres major muscle, it changes its name as the brachial artery. So, how and where the axillary artery begins? How and where the axillary artery ends? So, axillary artery begins at the outer border of the first rib as the continuation of subclavian artery. And axillary artery begins, ends at the lower border of teres major to continue as the brachial artery. It is so simple. Now, the axillary artery is divided into three parts by the pectoralis minor muscle. Pectoralis minor muscle crosses the axillary artery anterior to it. You know, pectoralis minor, you finish your musculoskeletal block, You know, pectoralis minor muscle was deep to pectoralis major.
Yes.
It was coming from the third, fourth, and fifth ribs, and it was going to be inserted on the coracoid process scapula. And you know that the pectoralis minor muscle, it formed also the anterior fold, part of anterior fold, and pectoralis minor muscle crosses the axillary in front. So this pectoralis minor muscle divides the axillary artery in three parts, or you can say the axillary artery is divided in three parts by the first part above, second part behind, third part below. First part is above the pectoralis minor muscle. You can say from the outer border of the first rib to the upper border of pectoralis minor. Second part is behind the pectoralis minor, and third part is below the pectoralis minor. It means from the lower border of pectoralis minor to the lower border of teres major. So axillary artery is divided in three parts by the pectoralis minor muscle. First part, second part, and third part. First part is above, second part is behind, and third part is below the pectoralis minor muscle. Now, relations of the axillary artery. You know, axillary vein is lying on the medial side of the axillary artery throughout its course. In all parts of the axillary artery, axillary vein runs medial to it. So axillary artery in the axilla is lying lateral to the axillary vein. Okay? Now, the important relations of the axillary artery are with the brachial plexus. You know the parts of the brachial plexus? Roots and trunks and divisions and cords and branches. You know it? Okay, very good. So what are the relations of brachial plexus with the axillary artery?
The point.
Very easy. You know, I think you have studied the brachial plexus, the cords, and you studied that the name of the cords of brachial plexus,
yes,
lateral, medial, and posterior, were put according to their relations with the second part of the axillary artery. Okay? It means that lateral cord is lying lateral to the axillary, second part of axillary artery. Medial cord is medial and posterior cord is posterior. So to the second part of axillary artery, it means behind the pectoralis minor muscle, lateral cord is lateral, medial cord is medial, and posterior cord is posterior to the second part of axillary artery. It's very clear?
Yeah. Yes.
Very clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, about the third part. You know, cords give branches. To the third part of axillary artery, the branches of the lateral cord are lateral. Branches of the lateral cord of the branches of lateral cord of brachial plexus? Yes, lateral pectoral nerve, lateral root of median nerve, and musculocutaneous nerve. Now, branches of the posterior cord of brachial plexus are posterior. All, without exception, all the branches of posterior cord of brachial plexus are posterior. And what were the branches of posterior cord of brachial plexus?
Yes.
Yes. Upper subscapular, thoracoid, dorsal, lower subscapular, axillary, and radial. Okay? There were five branches of the medial cord, you know, medial pectoral nerve, medial root of median nerve, of medial cutaneous nerve of R, medial cutaneous nerve of 4R, and ulnar nerve. No. All the branches of the medial cord of brachial plexus are medial to the third part of axillary artery with one exception. Medial root of median nerve is anterior to the third part of axillary artery. It's very clear in this picture because it is small, but you can see this is medial root of median nerve. Because medial root of median nerve joined with the lateral root of median nerve to form the median nerve. So median nerve is formed by branch from medial cord, by branch from lateral cord. So again, now I'm revising the relations of the third part of axillary artery with the brachial plexus. ventricle. Branches of the lateral cord of brachial plexus are lateral. Branches of the medial cord of brachial plexus are medial except one. That is medial root of medial nerve, that is anterior. And branches of posterior cord of brachial plexus are posterior to the third part of axillary artery. It's very clear? It's very clear. Now, what about the first part of axillary artery? If you see the first part of axillary artery here, medial cord of brachial plexus is posterior. And posterior cord and lateral cord are lateral. Lateral cord is lateral, posterior cord is lateral, and medial cord is posterior. Again, important relations of axillary artery with the brachial plexus. So we divide in relations of three parts, relations of the first part of axillary artery. Medial cord of brachial plexus is posterior. Posterior cord and lateral cord are lateral to the first part of axillary artery. It's very clear?
Yes.
Second. To the second part of axillary artery, medial cord is medial, lateral cord is lateral, and posterior cord is posterior. Okay? Now, to the third part of axillary artery, branches of the lateral cord are lateral. Branches of the posterior cord are posterior, and branches of the medial cord are medial except the median root of except the median root of median nerve, that is anterior. It's very, very clear? Easy? I'm slow now? If I'm fast, please you raise hand and make me slow. Now, what about the branches of axillary artery? No, in any, when you study any artery, the important points in artery are where and how it begins, where and how it ends, the course, important relations and branches, that's of nothing more than this. The branches of axillary artery, from the first part is superior thoracic, from the second part is acromio-thoracic and lateral thoracic, and from the third part is subscapular and anterior circumflex humeral and posterior circumflex humeral. So it's very easy to remember. From the first part, one branch. From the second part, two branches. From the third part, three branches. One branch from the first part, two from the second, three from the third. And when I was a student, I memorized these branches with the mnemonic CLCF. Cell sap are the branches of axillary artery. What is cell sap? Superior thoracic, acromio thoracic, lateral thoracic, subscapular, anterior circumflex humeral, and posterior circumflex humeral. So one branch from the first part, two branches from the second part, and three branches from third part. Clear?
Yes.
There are some branches of acromio-thoracic artery. So pegged are the branches of acromio-thoracic artery, pectoral, acromial, clavicular, and deltoid. So pect are the branches of acromio-thoracic artery. The other name is thoracoacromial artery. Its name is thoracoacromial or acromio-thoracic artery. So very easy. Now what are the branches of axillary artery? From first part, superior thoracic. From the second part, acromio-thoracic, lateral thoracic. From the third part, subscapular, and anterior and posterior circumflex, you know, anterior and posterior circumflex humeral artery wind around the surgical neck of humerus with axillary nerve. That's why in case of fracture of the surgical neck, there is results in paralysis of deltoid and teres minor. Deltoid paralysis will result in loss of abduction for 15 to 19 minutes. So this is, these are the branches of axillary artery. You see? Sag. Any question? No. Begins, ends, relations, branches, and anastomosis. Now we will discuss about the anastomosis around the scapula. This anastomosis exists between branches of first part of subclavian and third part of axillary. Third part of axillary which branch? Subscapular branch. Subscapular branch give artery, that is circumflex branch. This is from the third part of axillary and from the first part of subclavian, you know there what the branches of subclavian artery? Yes, vertebral artery, internal thoracic artery, thyrocervical trunk, costocervical trunk, sometimes dorsoscapular. Thyrocervical trunk gives three branches. Which branches? Inferior thyroid and suprascapular also. So suprascapular branch, yes, suprascapular branch of thyrocervical trunk branch of subclavian and dorsal scapula. So these are the branches of subclavian and circumflex branch of subscapular is the branch of third part of axillary. Anastomosis exists around the scapula. Now we come on brachial artery. So brachial artery beginning is very easy. The brachial artery begins where? At the lower border of teres major muscle. How? As the continuation of and it ends at the neck of the radius. We have two bones in the forearm. Lateral one is radius and medial one is ulna. Ulna. So when the axillary, so brachial artery runs from medial side, inclines forwards in front of the arm, enters in the cubital fossa, and then when it reaches at the level of neck of the radius, it ends by dividing into radial artery and ulnar artery. This is how it is divided. Radial artery and ulnar artery runs downwards and lateral from medial side of the arm to front of the forearm, you can see to front of and in the enter in cubital fossa. Cubital fossa. You know the boundaries and contents of cubital fossa very well. What are the branches of brachial artery? The branches of brachial artery, it must supply the muscles of the arm. It must be muscular branches, yes. And there is a profunda brachii artery. Like we have profunda femoris in the front of the femoral in the thigh, we have profunda brachii artery as a main and big branch that supply the muscles of the posterior compartment of arm. What are the muscles of posterior compartment of arm? Triceps. Inferior, ulnar, collateral branches, they take part in anastomosis around the elbow joint. So these branches are lower down. So we have this branch profunda brachii artery, and then we have superior ulnar collateral, inferior ulnar collateral, and two terminal branches are radial artery and ulnar artery. So brachial artery begins at the lower border of teres major as the continuation of axillary artery. It ends at the neck of the radius by dividing into radial artery and ulnar artery. And its branches are muscular and profunda brachii and superior ulnar collateral, inferior ulnar collateral, and terminal branches are radial ulnar branches. Okay? Easy. Here I have not given the branches of acromion, thoracic, profunda brachii, but I think this is radial artery. So where the radial artery begins?
Neck of the
radial artery begins where? At the neck of the radius. How? Yes, as a terminal branch of the brachial artery. So radial artery begins at the neck of the radius as a terminal branch of brachial artery. Okay. Radial artery. Yes. From here, it inclines from the medial side of pubital fossa laterally and runs in front of lateral side of forearm, enters in anatomical chin of box. You know anatomical chin of box, you know boundaries of contact? And then it continues in the palm as the deep palmar arch. As the deep palmar arch. Okay? What are the branches? The branches are in the forearm and branches in the palm. In the palm, branches are princeps, pollicis, radialis, indicis, first dorsal metacarpal, first dorsal metacarpal, princeps, pollicis, radialis, indicis. Okay. Princeps, pollicis here, radialis, indicis here, and first dorsal metacarpal here. So these and in the these are the branches in the palm, in the hand, and in the forearm written muscular radial recurrent, palmar carpal, and superficial palmar. You know, muscular branches supply to the muscles of the forearm, and radial recurrent is the branch from the upper part. It take part in anastomosis around the elbow joint. And palmar carpal branch is here in front of the palm in the lower part, and superficial palmar branch joined with the termination of the ulnar artery to complete the superficial palmar arch. So these are the branches of radial artery in the forearm and in the palm. In the forearm, branches are muscular branches, very good, and radial recurrent and palmar carpal and in the hand, first dorsal metacarpal and princeps pollicis and radialis indicis. Okay, now we come our ulnar. How and where the ulnar artery begins?
Termination.
Very good. Ulnar artery must begin at the neck of the radius as a terminal branch of
brachial.
Very good. Very good. And where and how the ulnar artery ends? Ulnar, yes, ulnar artery ends in the palm to continue as the superficial palmar arch. You know, in the palm there are two palmar arches are formed, superficial palmar arch and deep palmar arch. So which palmar arch is formed by which artery? When I was a student, I was confused. Sometimes I was saying superficial but radial in exam. So I memorized this thing like this by doctor. I memorized by doctor. Doctor means deep palmar arch is formed by the radial.
Or
must be the okay. So deep palmar arch is formed by the radial. Remember by doctor. Ulnar arch. Okay. What are the branches of ulnar arch? Branches of ulnar artery. Muscular branches, anterior ulnar recurrent and posterior ulnar recurrent. This anterior and posterior ulnar recurrent arteries, recurrent means they ascend upwards and they take part in anastomosis around the elbow joint with the superior and inferior ulnar collateral branches of the profunda brachii artery. So these are the branches are muscular, anterior, posterior ulnar recurrent and common interosseous artery. Common interosseous artery divides into anterior interosseous and posterior interosseous artery, and remember that the structures passing through the fourth compartment of extensor retinaculum of the wrist joint was anterior. Remember structures passing through the compartments,
yes.
Four tendons of extensor digitorum. So these are the branches of ulnar artery. superficial and deep palmar arch. This we know that superficial palmar arch is formed in the palm by the ulnar artery and is completed by the superficial palmar branch of radial artery. And deep palmar arch is formed by the radial artery and it is completed by a superficial palmar branch of ulnar artery. Now these are superficial palmar arch and deep palmar arch. This is very This is ulnar artery. Ulnar artery is forming superficial palmar artery. So this is completed by a branch from the radial artery. And this is radial artery from the deep palmar arch. But deep palmar arch is completed by a branch from this, from ulnar artery. Deep branch from ulnar artery. Before I said superficial, deep palmar branch. Clear?
So now doctor. Superficial palmar itself. Ends in the palm of superficial palmar.
Now arteries of the upper limb.
Adjust the arch.
Easy? Axillary artery begins, ends, relations, branches. Brachial artery begins, ends, branches. Easy? Now veins of the upper limb. Upper limb we have superficial veins and deep veins. Deep veins, you know, accompany the arteries. Like we have superficial and deep palmar arch, we have ulnar vein, radial vein, brachial vein, axillary vein, subclavian vein. Now we will talk about the superficial veins. Superficial veins of the upper limb, most veins join to form the two veins. On the lateral side we have cephalic vein, on the medial side we have basilic vein. Cephalic vein and basilic vein. Cephalic vein opens or drains or tributaries in the axillary vein and brachial vein becomes continuous with the axillary. So we have two veins. On the lateral side, cephalic vein. On the medial side, basilic vein. So cephalic vein and basilic vein. Basilic vein becomes continuous at the lower vertebral major and the axillary vein. And this cephalic vein joint opens in the axillary vein.
So both of them choose and things.
Okay. Yeah. Cephalic vein is larger than the basilic vein. Are best utilized, yes. These veins utilized for IV injections. Yes. This most suitable site for IV injections in normal persons. But in dehydrated we may cut down in direct surface. Okay, this. This is what I say. We have two veins, dorsal venous arch is here. So we have two veins. These superficial veins are really not present in the palm at pressure points and under border of forearm, back of the arm and the scapula, this trapezius region. So this on the lateral side we have cephalic veins that join the axillary vein. On the medial side we have basilic vein that form the axillary. Now cephalic vein. From cephalic vein it starts from lateral end of dorsal venous arch and it joins the axillary vein and course. Now its course is, you can see from anatomical sinus box. Your cephalic vein was a content of in the roof of the anatomical sinus box and then courses in the lateral side of the forearm in front of the elbow. And then it pierces the clavi pectoral fascia. You know the structures piercing the clavi pectoral fascia? Which was structures? Yes? Cephalic vein and acromiothoracic artery, lateral pectoral nerve and lymphatics. Four structures was piercing clavi pectoral fascia here between the pectoral major pectoral fascia, you know all this. So this cephalic vein pierces the clavi pectoral fascia and then it joins and then enters into the axillary vein. Basilic vein is formed from medial side or medial end of the dorsal venous arch of the hand and then it continues in the axillary vein. Course, medial border of forearm, then in front of the elbow, then in lateral border of teres major. These are superficial veins here. On the lateral side, we have cephalic vein. On the medial side, we have basilic vein. This is cephalic vein, this is basilic vein. But there we have two other veins, median cubital vein. This is median cubital vein, is vein that join the cephalic vein and basilic vein in front of the elbow. In front of the elbow, yes, you can see the roof of the cubital fossa. The superficial veins run in the superficial fascia. All the superficial veins run in the superficial fascia, and this median cubital vein, it crosses the roof of the cubital fossa, and it drains blood from cephalic to basilic. This is median cubital vein. And one vein is median vein of forearm. It's formed from the plexus here, then it runs in front of the forearm, that it joined here in front of the elbow, either in cephalic or in basilic. So this vein is coming, this is median vein of the forearm, and this is median cubital vein. Usually we give injection in the median cubital vein or cephalic or basilic. So this is median cubital vein is this. This joint, the cephalic vein with the basilic. This is median cubital vein, and this vein is median vein of forearm. It joins the cephalic or basilic. So nothing, in the veins of the upper limb, nothing. Superficial vein is cephalic and basilic. Cephalic lateral side, basilic medial side. Cephalic open in the axillary, basilic continue as the axillary. And we have median cubital vein and median vein. Now we come on arteries of the upper part. Now, arteries and veins of the lower limb is clear to all of you? There is no problem?
No problem.
Upper limb problem? Class. Now, lower limb. Lower limb arteries are nothing. Arteries of the lower limb are
nothing.
Only femoral. Then the femoral artery becomes popliteal artery. Popliteal artery divides into anterior tibial and posterior tibial. Anterior tibial becomes dorsalis pedis, and posterior tibial divides into lateral plantar and medial plantar. That's all. Class. Nothing. This is. This diagram is. Okay. I make the diagram. Okay, now we are discussing the arteries of the lower limb. You know that we had from left ventricle of the heart, we have arch of aorta, that it becomes the ascending aorta, it becomes arch of aorta, it becomes descending thoracic aorta, where? At the lower border of T4. Then descending thoracic aorta becomes abdominal aorta at the lower border of T4. Abdominal aorta then divides in
common
in right common iliac and left common iliac arteries at the sacroiliac joint. Okay? law. Common iliac artery then divides internal iliac artery and external iliac artery. Internal iliac artery divides into anterior division and posterior division and supply the organs in the pelvis. External iliac artery enters into the thigh by passing behind the inguinal ligament at the midpoint of inguinal ligament, halfway between the anterior superior iliac spine and pubic tubercle, and it changes its name as the femoral artery. Now we can say that the femoral artery begins at the midpoint of inguinal ligament behind the inguinal ligament at its midpoint as the continuation of okay? Very good. So this is external iliac artery. And this is in power. So the femoral artery begins behind the mid inguinal point as the continuation of as the continuation of external iliac artery. Okay? Now where it ends? Femoral artery runs in the front of thigh downwards and medially when it reaches at the junction of upper two-thirds and lower one-third of medial side of thigh, it enters in an opening in the adductor magnus and changes its name as the pubic artery. So we can say the femoral artery ends at the junction of upper two-thirds and lower one-third of medial side of thigh by passing through an opening in the adductor magnus to continue as why popliteal artery? Because it enters in the popliteal fossa. Why here its name? A femoral artery? Femur means thigh. Femoral artery, femoral sheath, femoral nerve, femoral canal, femoral lip. Okay. So this is femoral artery. What are the branches of femoral artery? You know that upper half of the femoral artery runs in the inguinal femoral triangle and lower half in adductor canal. Upper half of the femoral artery runs in the femoral triangle and lower half in adductor canal. Its upper four centimeter is enclosed in femoral sheath. Understand? You have what was femoral triangle? Femoral triangle was a muscular triangle in upper one third of front of thigh. It was bounded by the inguinal ligament and medial border of sartorius and medial border of adductor lamus. And this is femoral artery, upper half femoral artery is the femoral triangle and adductor canal or Hunter's canal or subsartorial canal was present in the middle one third of thigh and it was, you know, the boundaries and femoral artery lower half front finish. And upper 4 cm of femoral artery is enclosed in the femoral sheath which was a funnel shaped sheath formed by the fascia transversalis and fascia iliaca, and it contains femoral artery and femoral vein. Okay, so this is about the femoral artery. Okay, very easy. Femoral artery begins behind the inguinal point and the continuous vestibule, ends in the upper at the junction of upper two-thirds and lower one-third of thigh by passing through an opening in the adductor magnus to continue as opening. Its upper half is femoral triangle. Lower half in outer canal, upper 4 cm in femoral sheath. Okay. Now, what are the relations? These relations you know from your musculoskeletal block. Femoral vein was medial, femoral nerve was lateral. You remember? Femoral vein was medial, femoral nerve was lateral. know this very well. So what are the branches of femoral artery? Branches of femoral artery is very, very easy. I think you already know, no need to memorize all these branches. Because they are three superficial. Superficial circumference iliac, superficial epigastric, superficial external pudendal, then some deep, four deep, deep external pudendal, and profunda femoris, and muscular, and descending genicular.
Three superficial now for deep
doctor. Descending genicular, descending genicular. Yes. Yes. There are three superficial and four deep. Seven branches,
seven.
So femoral branches of the femoral artery is very easy. You know, three superficial, superficial epigastric, superficial circumflex iliac, superficial external pudendal. So superficial epigastric runs upwards to supply the lower part of anterior abdominal wall, and superficial circumflex iliac towards lateral side, and superficial external pudendal medially towards the skin of external genitalia. So this is three superficial branches and four deep, deep external pudendal and profunda femoris. Profunda femoris is a big artery. It gives four branches, and muscular branches to muscles of the anterior and medial compartment of thigh, and descending genicular artery from lower part that take part in anastomosis around the nephroid. So these are the branches of
femoral.
So in arteries, the upper and lower limb branches of axillary artery are important, and branches of femoral artery are important, and branches of brachial artery are important. So what are the branches of femoral artery? It's very easy. Three superficial, superficial epigastric, superficial circumference iliac, superficial external pudendal, and four deep, deep external pudendal, and profunda femoris, and muscular, and descending genicular. Okay? Okay. Profunda femoris artery gives two branches, medial and lateral circumflex femoral arteries and perforating arteries there. Four perforating arteries and muscular branches to the muscles of posterior compartment of thigh. It means which muscles? Biceps and two semi muscles. What are two semi muscles? And there are branches, two branches of lateral and three branches of medial muscle, ascending, descending, and acetabular artery. Now popliteal artery. Where and how does the popliteal artery begins? Popliteal artery begins at the junction of upper 2/3 and lower 1/3 of medial side of thigh in an opening in the ductal magnus as the continuation of
femoral.
Okay? And it ends in the popliteal fossa at the lower border of popliteus. The popliteus muscle was there. Remember?
Yes.
Here?
Yes, to unlock
the knee joint. So at the lower border of popliteus muscle, this popliteal artery ends by dividing into anterior tibial and posterior tibial. Here it divides into posterior tibial and anterior tibial artery. The branches of popliteal artery are, there is one cutaneous branch that is sural, it supplies some muscles, and there are two terminal branches that are anterior tibial and posterior tibial, and other branches are to the knee joint. There is superior lateral genicular, superior medial genicular, inferior lateral genicular, inferior medial genicular, and middle genicular. So these are five branches to the knee joint. These five branches join with the descending genicular of the femoral to complete the anastomosis around the knee joint. Other branches of one is cutaneous, that is sural, and one is muscular, and two terminal. So nothing. Popliteal artery branches, nothing, not to need to remember, it's already very easy. Five genicular branches, and sural, and muscular, and terminal. Now femoral artery and popliteal artery. Class done. Anterior tibial artery. Where and how does the anterior tibial artery begins? At the lower border of popliteus as a terminal branch of. And it ends where, you know, this anterior tibial artery runs in the anterior compartment of leg, then in the dorsum of foot. Then between the two malleoli and the dorsum of foot, it changes its name as the dorsalis pedis artery. Dorsalis pedis artery perforate enters through the cleft between the first and second toe. So this is anterior tibial artery. Anterior tibial artery ends at the dorsum of foot between the two malleoli to continue as dorsalis pedis artery. I think dorsalis pedis artery was also this us, which artery will palpate. So dorsal pedis artery. What are anterior of leg? What are the branches of anterior tibial artery? Anterior tibial recurrent, posterior tibial recurrent, anterior medial malleolar, anterior lateral malleolar, and muscular branches. Posterior tibial artery, where it begins? At the lower border of popliteus as a terminal branch of. And it ends behind the medial malleolus. This is medial malleolus. So between the medial malleolus and calcaneum. You can say behind and below the medial malleolus, it ends by dividing into lateral plantar artery and medial plantar artery. These medial and lateral plantar arteries enter in the sole of the foot and supply the muscles of the sole of the foot. How many muscles were in the sole of the foot? 18 muscles. Okay. Remember the name? Muscles of sole of
foot? Or layer.
And the structures passing through the flexor retinaculum. You remember?
No.
Two doctors are not here. What are the branches of posterior tibial artery? Circumflex fibula, that is peroneal, nutrient, communicating, medial malleolar, and calcaneum. Now, we finish arteries of lower limb. Any problem in arteries of lower limb?
No.
So easy. Axilla and brachial. Anterior tibial. So easy. Veins of the lower limb. We have superficial veins, deep veins, and communicating veins. You know, deep veins, we have not studied the deep veins because the deep veins accompany the arteries. We have anterior tibial vein, posterior tibial vein, popliteal vein, and femoral vein. And femoral vein is medial to the femoral artery. And in the popliteal fossa, you know, popliteal vein was in between, in the middle part, tibial nerve and popliteal artery. Perforating veins connect the superficial and deep veins, and they permit only one vein, the flow of blood from superficial to deep veins, and they have deep veins. Superficial veins. Superficial veins, we have two superficial veins in the lower limb, that is great saphenous vein and small saphenous vein. Both are important. Great saphenous vein is more important. You have to know the great saphenous vein and also the small saphenous vein. And then tributaries. Great saphenous vein. Great saphenous vein is formed as a continuation of dorsal arch on the dorsum of the foot. Dorsum of foot from medial and abdorsal arch of veins. So great saphenous vein is formed on the dorsum of the foot and the continuation of dorsal venous arch of foot. Then it runs upwards in front of medial malleolus, then medial side of leg, inclines behind the knee joint, then inclines forwards, runs, ascends in the thigh, pierces the saphenous opening, and pierces the cribriform fascia. Passing through the saphenous opening, and open in the femoral vein. You know, this is big vein. Coming from here, diagram must be here. This is great saphenous vein. It is formed at the medial end of dorsal venous arch up in front of medial medullus, then along the medial side of leg, then runs behind the knee joint, inclines forwards to reach the saphenous opening, pierce the cribriform fascia and open in the femoral. What are the tributaries? Tributaries, the four tributaries are corresponding to the first four branches of femoral artery. That is superficial, circumflex, iliac, superficial, epigastric, superficial, external pudendal, and deep external pudendal. Four easy. Must be perforating veins. Must be communicating veins. Medial marginal vein of sole and accessory saphenous vein. Small saphenous vein is formed as a continuation of lateral and of dorsal venous arch of foot. Okay? And it runs by passing behind the lateral medullus that enters on the posterior aspect of leg. In the middle of back of leg, then it enters in the popliteal fossa, pierce the popliteal fascia, and then join and open and drain in the popliteal vein. So small saphenous vein doesn't enter in the thigh. Great saphenous vein enters in the femoral vein, and small saphenous vein enters in the popliteal vein. These veins are important because in dehydration, usually in case of burns, when superficial veins are not found in the arms, so we make a cut down and we give IV, maintain IV line in the great saphenous vein. And varicose and ulcers, varicosities are common in this great and small saphenous vein. And I think you have a case of varicose.
No.
And cough, pump and peripheral heart. You know, deep veins are important for the cough, for peripheral heart, because in running, these cough muscles, cough means posterior of the leg, posterior compartment of the leg. So this contraction of the muscles help to propel the blood and to drain the blood from the veins of the leg. So these muscles are called the peripheral heart. So this is important in this. So these are the applied anatomy. We have 3 points: peripheral heart and varicosities, and for maintenance of IV line in dehydration cases. Theme. Any questions? Any questions in arteries of upper limb? In veins of upper limb? In arteries of lower limb? In veins of lower limb? Again, in 5 minutes, 5 minutes revision. In 5 minutes revision. Again. Again in 5 minutes.
Everything is recorded. We can revise in the morning. As you can.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
نشوف البطل
حق العلم النفسي قصدك الاستماع سمرا
واحد اثنين ثلاثة أربعة خمسة ستة سبعة ثمانية تسعة عشرة 11 12 13